Today we're going to be talking about a very common disease of the heart known as sakhatul qadr, which is basically hating the qadr of Allah, hating what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for you. Perhaps you were getting to know a sister for marriage or a brother for marriage and everything was going perfectly fine, and right in the last minute everything completely falls through and that person becomes a stranger to you and you don't speak to them anymore, and you hate that and you think, why me? Perhaps you had a job where suddenly they decided to let you go after being there for many, many months, and you were an amazing employee and you don't understand, why did they let go of me? Or they kicked you out and they gave you no reasons and you hate that. Why me? Perhaps you were at school and you've done so much revision for your exams, you get the results and you fail all your exams and you think, why me? This hatred towards the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what we're talking about here. The cure of this disease is to have certainty, absolute certainty, that everything that Allah does has a wisdom behind it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Hakim, the most wise. Everything He decrees has a wisdom behind it. And only once you have that certainty, then you can move on to the second thing that you need to have certainty in, which is what the Prophet alayhi salam said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Amazing, wondrous is the affair of the believer. This is what the Prophet alayhi salam is saying. Amazing is the affair of the believer. Everything that happens to the believer is good. Everything. Whether you perceive it as good, whether you perceive it as bad, everything is good, and that is only the case for the believer. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said. If you truly and surely believe in the Prophet ﷺ as a prophet of Allah, you know he does not lie, and you know that this hadith is absolutely true. And so when you have that realization, you'll think, okay, maybe Allah took that woman out of my life or that man out of my life because I would have destroyed them. Maybe Allah wants to teach me some things about myself before He gives me the right person. And maybe when you think about that job that they let you go from, you might think, well, actually, if I stayed in that job, maybe there could have been a serious car crash that happened, for example, that took my life as a result of it. Or when you think about the exams, perhaps that path that you would have taken during university, if you passed your exams, wouldn't have been a path that you enjoyed. And you start to see the world in a different way and you become happy with everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for you. And just remember the verse in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Perhaps you hate something, it's actually good for you. That's what Allah is saying in the Quran. And perhaps you love something, but it's actually bad for you. Allah knows and you do not know. Allah is a loving, merciful Lord. Don't hate His Qadr. Love His Qadr and say Alhamdulillah for everything. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this disease. Barakallahu feekum. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.